Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's see how the palladium catalyst is initially activated for the catalytic cycle. All the coupling reactions we've seen in this playlist require palladium to be in the zero oxidation state. But we always use palladium 2 salt, PdCl2 over the arrow. How does this work? Well, let me start by saying that not everyone does use a palladium 2 salt. There are sources of palladium zero. Regardless, most people use some kind of salt because it's more stable. So how do we get palladium zero to form in the reaction? I'm going to show a mechanism as if this is what really happens. Please consider this as a hypothetical mechanism rather than reality. Let's assume we're doing a Nagishi coupling. A Nagishi reaction is on top of the screen. All right, let's begin with PdCO2. We'll draw these PdCl bonds as if they are covalent. We have an organozinc reagent floating around. BrZn, R prime. This is a nucleophile, and we can consider the carbon-zinc bond to be covalent, as I've shown. But I like to show carbon-metal bonds as ionic for mechanisms. So this carbon can behave as a carbanion. It can attack palladium and displace one of these chlorines. This is not an SN2 reaction, but it is a substitution. This reaction can occur again. Another organometallic. That gets us here. The oxidation state of palladium is still considered to be +2, where it started. Now we have two R prime groups on the palladium atom. As we know from the catalytic cycle video, palladium can slip from between the R groups in a structure like this one. And this goes through what we call a reductive elimination, and we form a new biaryl. The R and R prime groups come together, plus palladium zero. This is how we get palladium zero. That's it. We started with palladium two. That's palladium +2. And now we have palladium zero. Once the palladium is reduced through this reductive elimination, it can go off and engage in the catalytic cycle. How much palladium catalyst is in the reaction? Not much. Normally it's only 1 or 2% in terms of moles of the aryl halide and organometallic reagent. So in order to reduce the palladium, you will use up a small amount, just a few percent, of your organometallic reagent. The organometallic reagent will be converted to this side product, which will be a biaryl. A few percent, that's not a lot, but it does form, and sometimes this new biaryl can be observed as an impurity in the reaction before we observe at the top of the screen our true final product, which is also a biaryl. So that's the rest of the story on our palladium catalyst. We can use a palladium 2 salt because one of our reagents, the organometallic, will reduce it to palladium zero, the oxidation state required to perform the catalytic cycle.